umamu wanje tari aha kukana azaku izo wakata ano na azaku kurekirisho mwili ya turahiyama.
And we have been married for 22 years.
Emyaka tuwaheza abu devero mbushwe.
And God has blessed us with 4 children.
Rahanga tuhilo mbusha nabili ilibana.
And some of 2 of them have been here with us.
Abamu habelele itu baba baria.
But my husband's father,
kwonga ishe womu anu anze,
I didn't see him. He died before we were married.
Sinda mule vrakatuwa wa stakashweri.
But he was a Moroccan.
Kwonga kabari yowu ishe mwe.
And so many people talked about him and about his testimony.
Abantu benshi bakandwa mugamba ho kandi bagamba na bijuru.
He was a very handsome man.
Akari ushejja obone iruwa kutumuka rite.
And women used to love him so much.
Kandi bakazi bakaba mweyendeza munonga.
And even him, he also used to love women, girls.
Angana we skata na okachira kumkunda kundamu.
But before he was born,
kuwakata kazeniwe,
his father was called Kakururu.
Ishe bakama mweta Kakururu.
And he had many children, and every time he would have children, they would die.
Na wakaba inabana weji kukakua vila mazara bambe bafa.
They would die before they have grown.
Bakaba bafa bataka kuzisi.
But he had a neighbor who was a Mnyoro man called Rwabwogo.
Akaba ine murano wongu Mnyoro ubalikota Rwabwogo.
And that man had many children.
Omshishu wakowe akaba inabana weji.
So when he had this boy, this now my late father-in-law,
kuyare rogu mwojo hatogo tatazara vito mjezi.
He said, maybe if I call him after that Mnyoro man, maybe he will live.
Ya gambati, kuna kumwete rizi na diawa Mnyoro, kumuna kaba.
Because the Mnyoro man was having many children and they were all living.
Hawa kumwongo mshisha u Mnyoro, akaina wana wengi, kani wana baruku.
So he called that boy Rwabwogo.
Ya yeta ogumojo Rwabwogo.
And that boy now grew. That boy lived.
Ogumojo yabaho yakura.
Now when he lived,
kuyabira hakakura,
when he was a young boy, his father died.
Omukunyeta kwe ishenho yatwariro.
So he remained with his mother and his sister.
Yaguma na nyina hamuna na munyanya.
After that, a few years passed, his mother died.
Hanyuma yecho kwile mchoko ahwaho nyina nawe yatwara.
He remained with his sister, now there were two.
Hati yaguma tugeize munyanya basagara bano munsi yaragaba.
They had a few cows and they were moving with their cows.
Bakabe naho entense barukugenda nazo.
When they were moving now, the sister also died.
Kubavile bali umuriyoro urugendo na munyanya nawe rwamutwara.
So he remained now alone.
Yasgara wenka omunsi.
With his few cows.
Na note bubuki.
Now when he was moving in that land, like where Mbirizi, around Mbirizi now.
Kuyabire na jenda omuyegyonsi nho Mbirizi hati.
So he found a girl, a very beautiful girl, and he got married to her.
Ya mukana nyonga mizi yempangare ya jita.
But the girl was very beautiful. She had dark skin, she had white teeth, and she was very beautiful.
Akugamana guakari nyonga mizi amisho amelo nge ishoche dekareka.
So he was very jealous of the wife.
Hati ya jere hari abo mukazi.
You
would fool her. Ya fool abo mukazi.
So he told the wife.
Ya gambo mukazi we.
That the day I hear you, if I have a problem.
Ya gatanaba inechisi.
And I hear you laughing with another man.
Ngakura no shakano nizo mshayi.
You would have killed me now completely.
No zakwa wani.
So one day he was looking after the cows. And he was in a field alone. Then a buffalo came and chased him. He chased him, he ran and climbed the tree. And the buffalo stayed around the whole day until evening, then it went. And so when he was coming down in the evening, he fell, and when he had climbed the tree, he had his spear, he had put it on the ground. So when he was coming down the tree in the evening, he fell on the spear. And the spear pierced him. So now he was hurt, he went back home when he was bleeding. He had slaughtered a white cock. Had slaughtered a cock and poured the blood on the door of the house.
Akawa yitire koko ya kwatesha kama ya jichera mu yango gwenji.
As an offering for him to get well.
Ngachitambo kugira ngo uno mama wakabati.
But when he didn't get well, after 2 months she got tired and she started going now in the boy the other men in the village.
Kwa tarabi ireje umushiara ya tanaka kujenda mucharo na nubojo gundi.
And one night when that old man Rwabwogo was in the house, he heard his wife laughing with other men.
And he now
he said, he heard a voice saying, "You see, your father died, your mother died, your sister died, your wife has left you, now you're also going to die."
Yavurira kariyamugira shwakafa nyoko yafa munyanya nyoko yafa bwana mukazi wono yakutsagaho icyasagaraniwe kufu.
But then he had another voice speaking to him.
Kukayije yavurira biraka.
And he had never heard that voice before.
Eniraka kata karhurra hoga.
And the voice said, "Rwabwogo, you are not going to die today."
Iraka yagira ngo Rwabwogo torokisha kuzo.
He said, the boy said, "You get up and leave this place. And I will show you where to go." And he got up, he left the house, he left the wife, he left everything. The voice led him to a camp of Barokore in Zimbabwe.
Yeyimuka yatsagaho kukazi yatsagaho ibintu irakaje amwebembera yamushyo rusisira rwabarokore Zimbabwe.
When he met the Barokore,
kiyabagabagaye barokore,
they preached the gospel to him.
Bamuburire njiri.
And he got saved.
Yajunwa.
Umukazi wanje nyarangwa yemerera abahubire. Umukazi wanje Patience. Yo mweta tangaza so mwenu Patience kukuru gamba bintuza ho umkazu wanja heriza hebiro bitano ground edge itro na murengiri na bebe mbeziba nkore ba district zona na bebe mbeziba madini mwenu hati ya jirangu deche kumtega nisakanda kujirira kakujia kugamba.